Hi everyone, this is a public service announcement to all you entrepreneurs out there, and it's very quick, and I just want to tell you to stop being an entrepreneur. And that's it. Now you can get back to whatever you're doing. First, before I get into it, I always say this at the end, but I'll say at the beginning this time. Don't forget to click thumbs up, click like, and don't forget to subscribe if you want more videos that deal with freelancing, with freelance translation, but for freelancers in general, freelancers, entrepreneurs, people who work online, stuff like that. And okay, now let's get back to it. So why do I say this? Why should you stop being an entrepreneur? Obviously, if you're an entrepreneur, if you're a freelancer, you're an entrepreneur, you know, and I'm a freelancer, I'm an entrepreneur, and obviously you're not going to stop what you're doing. You're not going to go start working for a company right now. But the reason I say this, and I've touched on this before in other videos, is that I see so many people chasing this entrepreneurship ideal, and it becomes like a false idol. It becomes something that people just want to say, I'm an entrepreneur, I'm a repeat entrepreneur, I'm a serial entrepreneur, you know, and I set up all these different preneurs. And the problem with this is that at the end of the day, no one really wants to do business with someone like that, right? I mean, no one wants to start hiring someone, whether it be a graphic designer, whether it be someone who provides widgets, whether, you know, someone who provides this or that service or goods or products or whatever, if they're not going to be in business in a month or two. And that's the problem with entrepreneurs. You get this feeling that they're always looking for the next thing out there, the next big thing out there. They're always looking to pivot, to change, to look for whatever is huge and can get them on the cover of some social media, something or other. And so you really need to. So most clients, when they're dealing with someone, after they get into it for a while, they want someone who's reliable, someone who they know will be there and who they can trust. And so you want this feeling, not so much that they're an entrepreneur, but that they've only been doing what they've been doing for a long time. And more importantly, they will keep doing it for a long time. If you're a graphic designer and you want to get hired, people want a graphic designer who really likes graphic designing, feels very comfortable with graphic design, and is going to keep being a graphic designer for many, many years and decades to come. And that's the kind of general feeling that people want. And so you kind of need to give that feeling. You need to exude that. You need to show that to other people. And I mean, look, if someone has a choice to hire someone who says, I'm a serial entrepreneur, I'm a graphic designer, I've also done this, I've also done that, look how dynamic, look how cool I am, look how hip I am. Or with someone else who's like, I'm a graphic designer and that's what I do. And I've been doing it for a while, many, many different designs, but nothing much else. And that's what I'm going to continue doing. Who do you think they're going to hire? Of course, they're going to hire the guy who just does graphic design and that's it. So you kind of want to give that feeling of being a good old boring kind of brick and mortar style business. And I say that in the sense that old fashioned type business, that's what you do. It's your calling in a way. And because then you sound less like an entrepreneur, less like a freelancer, and more like a business professional. So if you say, I'm an entrepreneur and I do graphic design, it's very different from saying, I'm a graphic design professional. And if you're a graphic design professional, that's what you do. That's it. And that's what you'll keep doing. And it just sounds that much more reliable, that much more steady. And that's what people prefer, okay? Because if you're hiring a graphic designer, then you need something designed, whether it be a website, but then later on you might need a logo and a brochure and stuff like that. So you might keep doing business with this graphic designer for the next year or two or more, because then you're going to have corrections or repeats or whatever it might be. And so you want someone who can be there for the long term. And if you want to get that person's business, you really need to show that you're there for the long term and stop trying to be all entrepreneurial about everything. Also, remember, for a lot of things like payment terms, when you get into it and when you deal with other businesses, payment terms many times are 30, 60, or 90 days out. But, you know, if someone's an entrepreneur and they keep going with what's cool or something like that, then you don't know if they're going to quote unquote pivot in 90 days and maybe they won't be there anymore. And that's kind of risky for someone and they don't want to take that risk. So that's all to say, obviously, if you're an entrepreneur and more power to you, these videos are for entrepreneurs. They're for freelancers. They're for people who do their own thing. So obviously, you're one of those if you're watching this. But you don't necessarily need to advertise that to prospective clients. That might not be the kind of feel you want to give them. And maybe you want to give them more of a feel that, oh, I found my calling, or this is what I do. This is my job as a professional, and that's it. Leave out the word entrepreneur. Leave out the word freelancer too, quite frankly. Or, you know, if you use freelancer, say freelance professional. But like in my course, I say, I recommend not using the word freelancer, but saying, if you want to be a translator, say translation professional, graphic design professional, whatever it might be, professional, you know, usually something like that works because it sounds a lot better than freelancer. And that's no matter what your business is. And this, that's the type of feel you want to give. You want to give not so much, I'm a freelancer entrepreneur, I'm kind of figuring it out and we'll see how it goes. But you want to say, no, I've kind of figured it out and this is what I do and that's it. And because people feel a lot more reassured with that and they feel a lot more secure. And so they're that much more likely to hire you, quite frankly. And so I think it's just kind of a switch of mentality that a lot of entrepreneurs need to make, because a lot of entrepreneurs get really excited about being an entrepreneur in itself and following the latest entrepreneur craze, but it kind of doesn't give the right feeling to prospective clients very often. And so you kind of need to step down on that. I mean, look, if you have that, that's great for you, but don't always exude that. Don't always, show that to the client, because that very often isn't the right type of image that you want to give to the client. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Let me know if you disagree with me, if maybe you think that it's good to always be entrepreneurial and be showing your entrepreneurship to prospective clients. I'm curious to hear about it, because in my experience, at least, that's not the case. And so I really think people should stop being an entrepreneur and to stop always saying how entrepreneurial they are and trying to chase this thing of entrepreneurship, this ideal of constantly being an entrepreneur, because it can backfire many times. So anyway, I hope you found that useful. And once again, I told you everything to do at the beginning of the video, and so I won't repeat it right now, but I'll just say I'll see you in the next video. Okay, thanks. Bye. Savedum.